Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I made this recipe before, but somehow the video got deleted. So I'm coming back to you guys live with a smokehouse bacon cheeseburger with an onion ring. This burger is something that you would get at a bar or a restaurant. It's delicious, and we're gonna make this right in our own home. So let's hop right into the video. So first things first, you wanna start off with your beef. Yes, I'm using ground beef, and preferably you wanna use 80% lean, 20% fat. The more fat, the better. Then I just took an egg yolk and some salt and pepper to taste, and I'm gonna season my burger, and then I'm gonna gently incorporate all the seasonings and the egg yolk together. You don't want to manipulate your beef too much, so just lightly toss in your egg yolk with your seasonings with your hands. I kind of split it into two because I'm making two burgers, so I split it into two so I can, you know, really make sure I get everything nicely incorporated, and I'm not gonna, as you can see, manipulate my beef too much. I'm just kind of like rolling it, tossing it around very, very gently. And once you do that, then you can form your burgers. Form your patties as big as you want to. I just like to do mine maybe about 1 inch thick, and then I do it the size of the bun. So it all depends on the buns that you're getting. I just got some local, I got some buns from my local bakery, and they were just the generic kind. And so I'm just going to shape my burgers to match the buns. Once you shape your burgers, you can then set them in the refrigerator until you're ready to cook them. So now I'm going to move on to my onion rings. Guys, this is a very, very simple thing to do. People are afraid of onion rings. I don't know why, but they're very simple to make. So I'm going to slice up a large yellow onion. I want the two outer layers of the onion, because those are the two largest layers, the two largest sizes of an onion. So once you get the two largest sizes out, then you just want to coat them, and then we're going to fry them. So simple. I know. I don't know why people don't make onion rings more often. So now we're going to make our batter. So I have 3/4 cup of flour, 1/4 cup of cornstarch, 1 teaspoon of paprika, salt and pepper to taste. I'm going to mix that all together and then add in some water. Add in about 1/2 cup at a time until you get it to like a pancake consistency. You know, the batter for a pancake. Till you get it to like a thick pancake consistency, something like this. You want to mix it all around. Make sure you don't have any lumps. And then you want to put some panko breadcrumbs in a bowl, and we're ready to coat our onion rings, or our onions, to make onion rings. So I'm just going to dip my onions in the batter first, and then I'm going to dip my battered onions into my breadcrumbs. This is going to give it a nice crispy, it's going to elevate your burgers, okay? You need an onion ring on top, or some sauteed onions. You need onions on a burger, in my opinion. But once you go ahead and coat your onion rings with your breadcrumbs, you can just set that on, you know, a paper towel or a rack or a cutting board or paper plate, whatever you want to use. And you just want to put that into your refrigerator and then let that sit in the refrigerator so it can get really, you know, stiff. It can, the breadcrumbs can get adhered to the onions. But once you are ready to fry them, you're just going to gently place them into your oil. I'm using vegetable oil, and let them fry until they're nice golden brown, something like this. Very simple, guys. You have two perfectly golden brown crispy onion rings that we're gonna place on top of our delicious burger. But before we make our burgers, we got to do a couple of things, okay? We gotta toast our bread. So first, I'm gonna put about 1/2 tablespoon of butter into my pan. I'm gonna use a saute pan, and just make sure the butter gets all around that pan. And then I'm just going to place my buns on my pan so it can get nice and crispy, because you don't want soggy buns on your burger. You just don't want it to fall apart. So once you get it to a nice brown, you know, got a little crisp on there, remove them and add your bacon. I'm adding 4 pieces of bacon to my pan, because I'm gonna put 2 pieces of bacon per burger. Once you get it to your desired crispiness, you know, it's your burger, you making it at home, you can do what you want to. Remove them, place them on a paper towel so they can drain. And once you do that, we want to take our burgers out of our refrigerator, and we're going to season them one more time before we actually cook them with just salt and pepper. And be very, very generous with your salt and your pepper. So you want to season with salt and pepper on both sides. And then once you do that, we are now finally ready to make our burgers. So I have my stove on a level 7, very hot. And I'm just going to gently place my burgers down, let them cook. Don't touch them. Let them cook. Depending on how thick your burger is, depends on how long you want them to cook per side. Mine is kind of thick, so I let mine cook for about 5 minutes. Then I flip them. You see that nice sear? Baby. Real nice. Once you do that, after about 2 to 3 minutes, place some cheese on there, whatever type of cheese you want to use. I'm using smokehouse cheddar cheese, and I'm just going to place one layer of cheese on there. You can place two if you want to, if you're feeling fancy. And then let that cook. Just let it cook until they look something like this. The way the house smell when you're making burgers, you know, beef, it's just delicious. But we got everything we need, so it's time for presentation time, because we all know presentation is key. So this plate, I think I got from Walmart or Target. I honestly don't remember, but we're going to take our toasted buns, the bottom half, and we're going to put that down first, and then put whatever type of condiment you want. I like barbecue sauce, but if you prefer mayonnaise or mustard, do whatever you want to do, guys, because this at your house. We're not in a restaurant. And then you want to place down your vegetables. So I'm using lettuce and tomatoes. You don't have to, but I like to. And then you want to place your juicy, delicious hamburgers. Like, we need a better close-up. Look at that. Place that on top of your tomatoes. And then we got bacon. Place 2 pieces of bacon on top of your burgers. And then, if you forgot, we have our beautifully crispy, cooked, fried onion rings. Delicious. And then we want to place the top half of our bun on our massively huge smokehouse bacon cheese burger with an onion ring. Add some fries in if you fancy, with a side of ketchup, and that's pretty much it, guys. So sorry the video got deleted. I don't know how it got deleted, but you guys know I cook all the time, so I was going to remake these burgers again anyway, so might as well record it. And that's it. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and make sure you wash your hands, and I will see you guys in my next video.